How much do you think of the world's wealth is hidden offshore? Take a guess. Millions of dollars? Billions? How about hundreds of billions of dollars? It's estimated that the wealth hidden in tax havens is equal to 10% of the global GDP. That's more than $8 trillion. But why on earth people would hide their money in the first place? Don't they want to brag about it? Why hide it when you can spend it to have an incredibly lavish life? Let me just make it clear. It's not the criminals who are hiding their money, but the world's largest corporations, Apple, Microsoft, Google, you name it, and the people who are running these corporations. It's a common practice, and it's 100% legal. However, the question remains, how do they do it? Isn't tax avoidance illegal? Well, let me explain. Let's say you start a company and everything is just perfect. Just in the first year, you have made an incredible profit of $100 million. Congrats, you are genius. Before you celebrate your success, IRS is going to knock on your door and take $21 million out of it, because the corporate tax in the United States is 21%. That's a lot of money. Why would you pay so much money to the government when you made that money with your blood and sweat? To be honest, that's still low, because before Trump, the corporate tax rate was 35%, which means you would have paid $35 million in taxes and would be left with only $65 million. But that's not the only bad news. Even if you decide to go abroad and sell your products elsewhere, where the tax rate is lower than in the United States, Uncle Sam will still come after you for its share of your profit on the top of the taxes you'll be paying in that country. Whether that's fair or unfair, it depends on whom you're asking. You can write down what you think in the comments below. However, things are not as bad as they seem. There is a way for you to avoid these taxes legally. Instead of declaring $100 million in profit, be smart about it. How about you lower your profit to just $30 million? And now suddenly, instead of the $21 million, you only have to pay $6.3 million. It's not difficult as it seems. Get on a plane and travel to the little island of Bermuda and set up a new company there. It's easy, fast, and would cost you almost nothing, because you wouldn't have stuff, building, or anything else, except an address to a small office in the middle of nowhere. Then simply give all of your patents, trademarks, and intellectual property of any kind from your real company that's in the United States to your new company in Bermuda. So when Uncle Sam comes to collect $21 million out of your $100 million, you can say, "Sorry, we have licensed this technology from this company in Bermuda, so we have to pay $70 million to them. So we're just left with $30 million. And now you only have to pay $6.3 million. Your $70 million in Bermuda are not taxed at all, because the corporate tax rate there is 0%. Congrats, you've saved $14.7 million. But how about the profit you earn in Europe? It will be taxed, right? Well, listen, you set up a new company in Ireland that's going to make another $100 million. Instead of paying 12.5% corporate tax in Ireland and the remaining 7.5% to the United States, you transfer that $100 million to a new company you set up in Netherlands at a 0% tax rate through a little tax loop. Your Dutch company immediately sends it back to your first Irish company that's simply a subsidiary of your Bermuda company. So the money ends up back at Bermuda, where the tax rate is 0%. Congrats, you have saved millions of dollars again. That's how Apple, Google, and many other giant corporations avoid and hide their money. It might not make a huge difference when you're earning millions of dollars, but when you're earning billions of dollars, saving even $1 billion would make a huge difference. So, when politicians increase or decrease the corporate tax rate, it doesn't really make a big difference, because why pay even a 10% tax rate in the United States when you can pay zero taxes in Bermuda? And you can't really blame them for that, because the ultimate goal of any company is to maximize profit and not pay more taxes. However, every strategy has its flaws, including this one. Having billions of dollars offshore is great, but what's the point of that if you can't use it? Because if you bring it back to the United States, you still have to pay taxes on it, which makes all that scheme is useless. But regardless, it still makes sense. When the United States lowers its tax rate, you bring that money back and invest it here. The US tax rate was 35%, but when Trump lowered it down to 21% in December of 2017, companies such as Apple aggressively started bringing back all the cash they've been hiding in offshore accounts for years. If you're watching the news, lately Apple started aggressively buying back its stocks, because you gotta do something with hundreds of billions of dollars that you suddenly got. That's why corporations started taking a different approach to avoid taxes, without an offshore account and in a much more sneaky way. Largest US companies such as Boeing, Netflix, Amazon, General Electric either pay zero in taxes or an extremely small percentage. From 2008 to 2017, Boeing paid only 8.4% and $54.7 billion in profit. In 2018, Netflix reported $845 million in profit but paid absolutely no taxes at all. The company can make a big investment and dramatically expand itself and gain market share. In fact, they might have to borrow money to do that, and at the end of the year, they will report a loss. And when you're reporting a loss, you are not only not paying any taxes for that year, but you can forward it to future years. So if you're going to make a significant profit next year, because last year you gained such a huge market share, you still can deduct your last year's loss and significantly reduce your tax bill, if not avoid it at all. And it's a common practice among the companies. The tax code has many loopholes that companies frequently use, such as tax credits on depreciation or research and development. Some go as far as paying their employees with stocks, so they're not only deducting it from their tax bill, but the company can create stocks out of thin air. So the company might not be making any profit. In fact, some companies keep on reporting loss year after year. Uber has a market cap of $50 billion, and it's making a revenue of a few billion dollars, but the company has not reported even a penny of profit. In other words, it hasn't paid a single dime in taxes yet. Even if Uber's valuation crosses $100 billion, it still doesn't have to pay taxes unless it reports a profit. That's why billionaires hide their money in stocks. Jeff Bezos started 2018 with a net worth of $100 billion and made another $40 billion by the end of the year, and paid absolutely zero taxes on those additional $40 billion. Because his wealth isn't liquid and consists entirely from Amazon shares, and he only has to pay taxes if he liquidates his shares by selling them. But as long as he doesn't have to pay any taxes. But what's the point of all of that wealth if you can't use it? This wealth is just on paper. Well, it's one way to think about it, but from the opposite point of view, what would you do with $140 billion in cash? As long as your company keeps growing, your wealth keeps growing as well. And if you want to drive a Bentley, fly private jet, or travel across the world and stay in the most expensive hotels, just use the company's money and then deduct it as a business expense and lower your taxes even further. When politicians talk about raising the taxes on the rich, they mean the doctors, lawyers, and engineers who work super hard to make hundreds of thousands of dollars, if not millions, and not the real rich people who will always find loopholes in these tax cuts to avoid all of those taxes. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Hit the like button and subscribe for more. Thanks for watching, and until next time.